Yo, what's up everybody? Today is, what's today? Today we're on Friday. Decided to start this day off with a Friday. I go to the post office, I got a package to drop off. As I said, I've been putting up for sale a lot of my colognes and my comic books and so forth. Not necessarily my manga, because my manga collection is newer. But with my comic books, I've been having them for a while. So the ones I've already read and I think I'm not going to reread, I've been putting them up for sale, making some space. And I'm going to... You know, I'm trimming down basically to try to keep it into just my favorite series and so forth, right? So I'm gonna just keep a few series and a lot of them I'm gonna go digital with. And my colognes, the ones I see I'm not wearing as much anymore, start selling, and then I'm selling some of those that I'm like, am I gonna reuse this again? Because I have so many, I'm never gonna finish all of them. So I was like, let me make some space, put some stuff up for sale, whatever I tend to use less and whatnot. So yeah, I've been doing a lot of that lately. So we got another package out today. My scent of the day for today is going to be this, Asaro Wanted. This is a great fragrance. It's something you can wear every day, especially like when it's like hot outside and so forth. It's a summer, spring type of fragrance. It looks pretty cool. It's like a revolver. So yeah, let's throw. It's pretty cheap too. It's like, you could get this one for about $30, and the regular, this is a smaller bottle. The regular bottle is about $40, so it's still really affordable. If you find this one on... like FragranceNet or Joma Shop, say pick it up, give it a try. By the way, those are websites where you buy colognes and perfumes and whatnot. All right, so I think you're checking out my spray routine right here. So I think we're ready to go, and I'll get back to you guys later. Go, go,
go, go. Girl, I turn that thing into a rainforest. Rain on my head. Call that brainstorming. Yeah, this is deep. Oh, but I go deeper. Make you lose yourself and find us keepers.
I got back home, decided to order some, I guess technically this is like Chinese food. It was from a sushi place. So let's see what I got right here real quick. So here it is, the jalapeno bombs. You get the jalapeno, then you get a bunch of these little jalapenos on top. And then this red sauce, which is almost like a teriyaki or barbecue type sauce. The jalapeno's deep fried, it's breaded and fried. So is the tuna inside. It's like baked, right? So it's like they bake everything in together. And it has probably more cream cheese than it does tuna. It's supposed to be half and half, but it felt like more cream cheese than tuna. I think it was $8.59, I believe, at the Bluefish. Overall, pretty good. It's good as an appetizer. This plate would not get you full on its own. There's something you would eat on the side with your main course. Here's my main course. It's going to be some chicken, broccoli, and some rice, steamed carrots. And this came with these packets of some sriracha chili sauce. It's pretty spicy. And of course, as usual, you're going to get the teriyaki sauce with it. All right, cool thing here is they gave me the options. They gave me some chopsticks and a fork. I'm pretty terrible with the chopsticks, so I'm probably just gonna go with the fork, you know. Keep it simple. So yeah, let's go ahead and see what these jalapeno bombs taste like. So it has jalapeno on the top. Inside they're stuffed with tuna and cream cheese. So let's go ahead and eat one of these. Depending on how much I like them, I might eat all of them right now, or I might just eat one and get to my actual main course, which would be this, the chicken and rice. They're like deep fried on the outside, kind of like your chicken would be. Ooh. They're really fucking hot. I mean, these things are hot. Has jalapeno on the top. As you can see here, it's a jalapeno. And on the top, it has more jalapenos. And it has some red hot sauce. And I don't know if this tuna has any spiciness in it, but this thing is kicking. It's very spicy. On 1 to 10, I have to put it up there like a 8 or a 9. Taking a second bite, it's not that bad. In the beginning, it's a lot of jalapeno, a lot of hot sauce. The second bite, once we're in the middle, it's more cream cheese and more tuna. So it's not as spicy. You start getting more flavor in. So overall, I do enjoy them. And the red sauce, it's actually more like almost like a teriyaki sauce. It wasn't hot sauce like I initially thought it was. So yeah, the rest of it is definitely more dialed back. On a scale of 1 to 10, how much do I enjoy this? It's pretty good. It's pretty good. This is definitely something I would reorder again. I don't think this would get me full though. It's like 10 bucks for four of these. I don't think this is something that would get you full. It's more like an appetizer or a snack you put on the side with your main course, right? So you order it as like an entree or whatever on the side. It is good though. The tuna's fine. It's tuna here is almost reddish. It almost looks like, you know, like marlin. If you ever tasted marlin before, the color of the meat is red. It almost gives off that kind of color here. It tastes real good. It seems to be baked. I guess like they baked it with the along with the jalapeno. So yeah, I give this somewhere around a 8. And if you're curious where you get this, it's called the Bluefish. And this one's called the Jalapeno Bombs. Like this teriyaki plate, obviously you saw it's a lot bigger than the jalapeno bombs. And it was also $10. It's $1 more than the bombs. So it was $20 for everything total. For this plate itself, $10 is not a bad deal. It's about what this Chinese food prices go for nowadays. And it doesn't come with a soda or anything, as you saw. I got my soda separate from 7-Eleven. So yeah, the chicken here, it looks like it's cooked pretty good. It's like charbroiled. Has a nice smell to it. Let's try it out. It's not bad. I threw some of the teriyaki sauce in it to give it a little flavor. It definitely tastes like if it was off the grill, then they just chopped it up, which is good because I like that kind of like that chicken al carbon, that type of style. Like when you eat those tacos, if you're a fan of Mexican food, you know what I'm talking about. So yeah, the chicken is decent. I give it like a 7. All right, let's give the broccoli a taste right here. There's steamed broccoli or supposedly steamed. It kind of sucks. It's not that good. I would give this like a 4. Wasn't a fan of the broccoli, and I do really enjoy broccoli. I'm a fan of it. This particular one is still kind of crunchy. I like it to be soft and moist when it's like well steamed. When it more of the flavor comes out, the juices. This is kind of dry, not a lot of flavor to it. Try out the rice. I already sprayed some teriyaki sauce on it, so. It's white rice. Can't expect much from white rice. It's the flavor of it. Anywhere you go, it's just in general, it's a kind of plain flavor. So to me, this is a 10 out of 10 as far as the rice. Not because it's the best white rice ever, but because to me, mostly all white rice kind of tastes the same. It's always, so it tastes just like it's supposed to. There's nothing different about it, right? Sometimes I even throw some butter on it just to give it a little flavor. So yeah, with the teriyaki sauce, it's, I mean, from what you expect from steamed white rice to be. Now let's get to the last thing, the carrots. Wasn't a fan of the broccoli, wasn't steamed very well. So I'm curious if the carrots. The carrots are okay. Give the carrots like a 8.5. They don't have any type of seasoning or anything. It's just plain carrots steamed. But they taste decent. A lot better than the broccoli does. Alright, so I didn't finish eating. I just ate about half of the food. Not because I didn't like it, just because I already feel full. So I ate half of the food. I was like, you know what? I'm no longer that hungry. So one thing I learned to do is not to force myself to finish a plate just because it still has food in it, right? It's one thing a lot of us make that mistake. It's like you're already full. You're like, well, I gotta finish what I had to eat the whole plate, right? The whole meal. And I know, like, I kind of trained myself to be like, you know what? I already feel full. Save the rest for later. It's perfectly fine. That way you get two meals out of one, right? And that way, you, without even knowing it, you're already eating less, right? So yeah, I might eat that later. Also, I don't want to get too full right now because let my food go down a little bit. I'm about to finish this book already. It's called Coffee Moon. It's a manga. So if you guys follow the channel, you might collect comic books and manga. Manga's basically like, it's same thing, comic books, right? But Japanese comics. So I'm about to finish this and I'm gonna do a work on editing a little video on it. Let me show you some of the art right here. Some of the art on this shit gets insane. I mean, look at this. Look at that. That shit is crazy. All those guns right there shooting up that car. It's very reminiscent of like the Bonnie and Clyde, the way they met their demise and so forth. So yeah, I'm gonna work on editing this video. and maybe sit down and read maybe a little more. And as I let my food go down, and then get started on a workout. So right now, since I just finished eating, when I finish eating, I take some of these BioFlex. One a day, always after your first meal and whatnot, right? Get you started on your day. All right, so I'm about to start my workout routine right now. I'm making my pre-workout drink, and I'm about done. Maybe enough for one more serving. So I was using this one, Enno Explode. And I thought it was pretty good. I like the results. I like the adrenaline I got with it. This was about 2 months worth. So it says you cycle, so take a month off. So I'll probably take maybe about a month off. And then I'm going to see if I buy a new pre-workout. I might try something different, not this one. So I could drop a review on it as well and kind of see the differences and whatnot, right? This one was really good for like $40. You got 2 months worth. So I thought it was a solid price for what you're getting. And you got good results. So if you want to see a review on that one, I have the link on the top over here. And got my drink ready. Now I typically like to wait about 10-15 minutes once I'm done with this. And then I start working out. You know, kind of let it kick in a little. Let your body soak in some of this stuff. And then I get the workout going. This was fruit punch, decent flavor. I just picked up my... I forgot I ordered some stuff from Walmart, and it just got here, some groceries, and it was some soda, some bread, donuts, milk, groceries, right? If you guys want to see some grocery videos, I could do those too, some Walmart hauls again, or some, whatever grocery store I go to. Let me know if you're interested in that, kind of see what kind of food I pick up and what kind of groceries. I'm going to let you know right now, it's probably not going to be the most healthy eating-wise. It's some healthy, it's a balance, you know, because I do get junk food like donuts and cereal and stuff like that. Actually, the cereal I get is usually pretty healthy. But anyways, I noticed they gave me this for free because Walmart, a lot of times they have like promotions and stuff. So they gave me this, this looks like a women's t-shirt. So I just gave it to somebody else. So yeah, they gave me this. And they gave me this, it says, naturally friendly hello. Anti-plaque whitening. Have not opened it. So yeah, it's some type of toothpaste. So whenever Walmart gets new products, like when they get because Walmart's a huge store. If you're starting your own brand of shirts, toothpaste, toothbrushes, you would love to work with Walmart, right? So if they accept you and they accept your products, they will give one of these to the customers, right? The people that order online and so forth. So they could try out, hey, we're now working with this company. So expect these products in our stores. So this is kind of what this is. I guess it's toothpaste. It says whitening. We'll be trying it out later. Not right now. Maybe I'll drop a review on it as well. And like I said, if you work with a company, everybody goes to Walmart, right? So if you're a company, you would love your product to be in that store because that way you don't even need commercials. People are in the store. They're going to see it once it's visible. Sales will go up, right? Because people can't buy what they don't know exists, right? So yeah, let me just drink my workout. And today, I think I'm going with, I think today I'm going to work out the shoulders. And I really need to make a video doing scheduling what workouts I'm going to do, what days. But right now, I'm going to do these. So what this is going to work out is the shoulder right here, the middle. You know, we have three muscles, one in the front, one in the back, and one in the middle. I guess what are these? The deltoids. So work out these in the middle, and they kind of slightly work out your back as well when you do both of them at the same time like that. So I'm gonna do about 5 reps of 10, being 50 of those, and then we'll start working out the back ones with this. I don't know what you would call it, like rows with back like that, so that we could work out the back one. So we're gonna work out the back shoulder and the middle shoulder. The front one with bench, you kind of get the front one working. So right now we're gonna work out these two, this one and this one.
Yeah, this is deep, oh, but I go deeper, make you lose yourself, and find us keepers, it go green light, go easy go, I like to taste that sugar, that sweet and low, but hold up, wait, new position, I put her on my plate, then I do the dishes, she my motivation, I'm her transportation, cause I let her ride. While I drive her crazy, then I just keep going like I'm racing. When I'm done, she hold me like a conversation. We said, babe.
When we're done, feel my legs. And when we're
so just hopped out the shower right now. I think today we're gonna go with this fragrance out of the shower. CK Escape, Calvin Klein Escape. I really enjoy this bottle. It's just kind of basic round bottle. The sprayer, it's the old school sprayers. That's just kind of basic, but they do throw out a lot of juice. Look at this. Yeah, that's real nice. So yeah, I'm gonna throw this on. Hit the shoulders. This kind of has an old school feel to it. It has like some cloves in here. So it has a old school fougere type of vibe. It's very cheap. You can find it on eBay for like 20 bucks. I don't mind throwing this one out of the shower, but this isn't gonna turn any heads. It ain't gonna get any compliments. It's just a nice clean smelling fragrance. It's usually the good ones I like to wear when I'm actually going somewhere. Something is something maybe citrusy, lemon, limes, oranges, stuff like that. So this one's just a nice out of the shower. It's a cheap fragrance, doesn't cost too much. So yeah, this one might be, after I wear it a few times and enjoy it, I might put this in a to sell pile and put a lot of my cheaper fragrances and just sell them all like at a bundle deal or whatever. So yeah, like I said, I think we were done today. I could do Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. I could do a few days in one video, but then I was like, that's gonna be like a 30-40 minute video. I don't know if you guys will stick around that long to watch the whole thing. So I'm gonna try to keep them at around 15 minutes. Today's workout, honestly, it wasn't my favorite. I know, you know, when you finish working out, you know when you feel you were working out your muscles. So today, when I was working out like this to work out the back over here, I started playing music and that just distracts me. So I noticed once I finished, I was like, you know what? I'm not feeling sore back here. I'm not feeling the workout. Like I was using my forearms more to push instead of my back over here, my triceps. I was using more my forearms and my elbows to push back like that. So you really wanted to concentrate on pushing with this and the elbows so you could work out this area. That's the whole point, right? So I felt it after. I was like, you know what? I feel sore over here and more over here. So I was like, it's supposed to be up here. So that kind of felt like a waste to me, but it is what it is. As far as the shoulder ones like this, yeah, that one I felt a good workout over here, so I was feeling it right there. I could feel the lines a little bit right here, like, you know, pumping a little while I was showering. But yeah, the second workout was a bit of a bust. Sometimes there's days like that where you're just not focused and you gotta focus on pushing with the muscle you're trying to work. So, you know, it is what it is. We'll get back to it again tomorrow. And right now, I'm just going to enjoy the game and, you know, stay tuned for the next video. If you want to, in the meanwhile, you want to check out another video, go ahead and click on right here, wherever it is. And that'll send you to my previous video. It's kind of like a vlog video as well. Other than that, I'd just like to thank you guys for checking out the video. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. That will keep you updated next time my next video drops. Other than that, I'll check you guys out next time.